back to my channel. With the weather becoming nice and cool, thought it'd be fun to create this nice recipe that you can enjoy with your kiddos, your roommates, your best friends, your parents, anybody, whether you are enjoying it through virtual class or on a nice Sunday morning with your choice of fall drink, whether that be pumpkin spice, chai, cider, even just traditional coffee. This recipe is a little modified. There are some fall-inspired spices and extra ingredients. You can keep them, you can take them out. Regardless, they're delicious. There's gonna be a lot more fun videos coming your way. So with that being said, let's get on our aprons and baker's coats and let's get baking. For the dough part of this recipe, you're going to need 4 cups of flour, 1/2 cup of granulated sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 1/3 cup of unsalted butter. You're also going to need 1 cup of lukewarm milk, 1 package of instant yeast, 2 eggs and 1 egg yolk, and finally, 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract. In your mixing bowl, add your flour, sugar, and salt. Then use your handy whisk to mix it all together. Once that is done, add in your butter. You can either mix it in with the dry ingredients with a fork, or if you're feeling adventurous like I did, use your hands. Once that's all together, bring your bowl over to the mixer and I let it mix with the machine going while I was getting the milk and the yeast ready. In a separate bowl, add in your instant yeast to your lukewarm milk and combine until the yeast is thoroughly dissolved. Once that is all ready, slowly add it in with the rest of the dry ingredients. Don't forget to scrape down your mixing bowl so everything can be thoroughly combined. Then add your 2 eggs and 1 egg yolk. And finally, your vanilla. Mix all together until the dough is nice and smooth. Scrape the mixer one more time, then it's time to transfer the dough from the mixer to the board. Lightly coat the board with some flour so the dough won't stick and it won't be a really sticky mess. I even put some flour on top and knead it until it is nice and smooth and well combined. Once the dough is nice and smooth, transport it over to a greased bowl and cover it with plastic wrap. And I cover the dough with a little bit more grease to help it rise. And set your timer for 1.5 hours or until the dough is twice its size. And while we're waiting for that, let's get on to the filling. You're going to need 1 cup of brown sugar, 2.5 tablespoons of cinnamon, 1 tablespoon of pumpkin spice, and 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. This step is pretty easy. Just take a spoon and mix all your ingredients until they are well combined.
Let me tell you, it smelled amazing in my house with that. After the 1.5 hour is done, pour your dough back onto the board. I missed the center, but it's okay. Sprinkle it down with more flour, both on the top and bottom, as well as the rolling pin, and roll until it's about 1/2 inch thick, 1/4 inch thick. You don't want it too thin, but you also don't want it too thick. If you feel that the dough is getting a little sticky, just add some flour to the bottom. That way you won't have any problems when you are rolling it. Keep rolling your dough until you have a nice rectangle you want to use, and then add the filling. To help make sure that the filling will stick to the dough, spread on 1/3 cup of softened butter all over. Once you have spread butter all over the dough, it is time to pour in your generous amount of brown sugars, pumpkin spice filling. I kid you not, my kitchen smelled amazing during this whole process. I loved making these. Once the filling is spread evenly throughout, it is time to roll. Be sure to take your time with this process to make sure that the dough isn't sticking to the board and you don't want any tears in your cinnamon roll. That would be upsetting. And also make sure that every ounce of that filling is nice and tucked into the dough. Once it is all rolled up, take your knife and cut out pieces that are about 2 inches big. I ended up using a bread knife because the ridges helped cut them very easily and there wasn't so much difficulty with the dough if it stuck. After you cut up all of your rolls, add them to your baking sheet. I coated mine in butter so they wouldn't stick to the pan. Make sure they're nice and packed. Although looking back, I probably should have just done 9 cinnamon rolls in here versus 12. I had a couple that were kind of undercooked because it was so packed, but 9 fit perfectly in this pan. It is a 9x9. Then cover in plastic wrap one more time and let it rise for a second time, but only for about 30 to 45 minutes. Don't forget to set your timer to 365 Fahrenheit. Then place them in the oven after the 30 to 45 minutes are done and have them bake for about 15 to 20 minutes or until they are golden brown. While those are cooking, we can get started on the delicious cream cheese frosting. You're going to need 4 ounces of cream cheese, 1.5 teaspoons of whole milk, 1 cup of powdered sugar, and 3 tablespoons of maple syrup. I ended up using a lot more maple syrup because I love that maple taste, but if you want it to be very subtle, keep it at the 3. If you want more, obviously add more. This process is pretty easy. Add in your cream cheese once it is done being a little troublemaker with me getting into the mixing bowl, and your powdered sugar, and mix until they are both well combined. Scrape the bowl one more time, then add in your milk and maple syrup. All right, the 15 to 20 minutes are done, and look at these rolls. They look delicious the way they are. The sugar is definitely caramelized and they smelled amazing, but we're not done yet. We definitely have to add the frosting. If you're not a huge fan of cream cheese, you can simply just add some milk and powdered sugar. Give the cinnamon rolls a little bit of time to cool, then add in your frosting and spread a generous amount all over. And that is it. You're all done with your fall-inspired cinnamon rolls.
Video, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe down below, and comment for any more fun recipes you would like me to try out, or even fun decorating ideas. I have a lot planned ready for you guys to finish off 2020, and I'm very excited to share them with you all. Hope everybody is still staying safe, have a wonderful fall, and I can't wait to see you guys in the next video.